I've basically got too much power for that boy, too much speed for that boy.
Because after this fight, you'll be dreaming of Marco Antonio Barrera.
Well, Jez, that's just the way it goes, my man. Tried so hard to knock him out.
He broke him down, yeah. You know, mentally, everything, you know, it was just, that was it for him.
And I'm gonna make history and bring it back to Sheffield, bring it back to England. Whoop, there it is. Harder and a better puncher and more dangerous than Barrera, Morales, all of them guys, and they never came to the table except Augie. Damn, I'm looking good. But Morales and Barrera will come 2001 when they want it. And when they want it, they'll get knocked out because I want it now. Thanking you.
What point did you decide you wanted to get in the ring with the best of the best?
It's not me that decided that I wanted to get in the ring with the best of the best. That's not happening. It's them that decided with me. I offered the fight with Barrera way before he took the fight, and he refused the fight. So you got a little bit, you mixed up a little bit, you're a little bit confused with that. Them guys stepped up to the table after I offered it them. And when I did offer it them the first time, they refused. And now is the time it's going to happen, because he's accepted. And all the rest of them cats, if they want it, they'll get it too.
Defensive standpoint, what will you do to keep him off balance?
Let him do whatever he wants to do. I believe in Allah, I'm a Muslim, and I'll be out there and I'll be ready to fight, and I'll be ready for anything and everything that he brings. I've basically got too much power for that boy, too much speed for that boy, and I'm going to prove it tonight that I'm the best featherweight in the whole world.
I'm boxing the best guy out there, and at this moment in time, I've got one guy on my mind, and that's Barrera. But I'm very, very confident, cool, calm and collected that I will dispose of my opponent and take him out in style.
Can't speak of Hala, but when they fight that night, it's going to be Marco Antonio Barrera and Ahmed, not Hala. He says all his talk about how he's going to knock me out and all the things he's been saying, he said tell him to get himself prepared well, because after this fight he'll be dreaming of Marco Antonio Barrera.
Pow! Pow! Oh, once you hit with them shots, it's over. Finished.
But, and he demanded to speak to the president of the MGM on a Saturday night, about 10:45 in the evening.
That is number one.
Número uno, Barrera.
Hey, listen, Barrera, they're going to kick his ass to this mess.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Proud to present the two best featherweights in the world. It's 12 rounds of boxing for the featherweight championship of the world. In his professional boxing career, he has been victorious 52 times, and 38 of those victories have ended by knockout. Only 3 times in 55 bouts has he been defeated. His professional record is a perfect one, consisting of 35 bouts, 35 victories, including 31 knockouts. And he is rated by most experts as, pound for pound, the most devastating puncher in boxing today.
Barrera believes that a victory would make them a hero in Mexico. The Prince believes that a victory will earn him recognition as a great fighter as well as a great showman. The stakes couldn't be higher.
Great lace referees in the business.
Boxing, not just waiting in. Gets to the body, wobbles, nails with a left hook upstairs.
Get into a slugging match with the Prince. But he allowed Barrera to taste his power against him.
Barrera is not looking in.
Interesting choice of fight plans, but and a couple of shots to the body. Round one is all Barrera as Prince Naseem takes several power shots from the Mexican star.
Corner may not be able to give advice. You got to work on his
eye. You can see the mouse under Nas's right eye as George pointed it out.
Now he's got Barrera clowning a little bit. That's what you want.
With their inflows, has his head, keeps his hands very high.
Lunging out there.
Of the Cesar Soto bout in Detroit, as Barrera is either pulled down by Hamed or pushes him down. Mark Ratner comes up onto the ring apron. Threat. Hard left hand by Prince Naseem, countering Barrera inside.
The Prince is the aggressor.
Right hand and a left by Barrera, rocking Naz back.
And he made him wait for a long time in that.
Perfect when he came back to the corner. Fighting the way he is.
Team is more effective as a counterpuncher rather than taking the lead.
Neck up. Why? What are you waiting on?
Barrera lands a jab. Prince Naseem grins. Barrera's got enormous reflexes, and he's getting hit here, perhaps more frequently than he expected. But Barrera.
So far, Barrera has neutralized the punching power of the Prince.
Not left hand.
Big left hand by Barrera inside. Stuns Prince Naseem. Naz smiling, but
boxer's doing it. He hasn't got in one position yet. Ooh.
No, George, because the guy.
Shooting the straight left down the middle.
Every round, Barrera should send him to the corner hurt with a good
foretelling blow.
Very composed, Barrera.
That was a hit, but there was
all right, second
right hand.
Fabulous about staying away from the Prince's power. Up for good hard shots.
Barrera is starting to connect with a left jab.
See the difficulty of trying to get the Prince Naseem's body, although Barrera. Big left hand by Prince Naseem.
You know he was here. I thought he would. He just stepped in with this.
Listen, you know. Listen. You let it.
Wave a hand on point. Okay, this fight goes the way it's going right now. You lose. You're gonna have to fight.
Hamed may have won this round. Short left hand. Didn't get it.
Run-of-the-mill club featherweight. Might throw 60 punches in a round. In this jab.
Not only so. He made him tuck his head just a little bit by telling him it looked damaged to you, rather than saying, there you are.
But there it is.
Whether the Prince has been thrown off.
Huge left hand by Barrera there.
Like Barrera.
Harold, how do you have it through six?
Okay, Jim, I got to throw him back to 57, three rounds apiece.
That's what Barrera is doing. He's pacing himself.
Barrera with a right to the belly and a left upstairs. And
Barrera doing. Clowning with a clown.
Big right hand to the body again by Barrera.
He's thinking now.
Picking up the pace with his jab. Throwing it more frequently. Landing it more often.
Yet, but he's starting to pick up the power.
With some royal blood.
Couple of left jabs onto the royal chin. Interesting rounds. Round seven. It appears, at least our up of his own, to appear to take a lead on
the mid round. Now for the first time, you see the Prince getting closer and closer to the ropes with it.
Partially blocked. One landed solidly. And the jab. Naz stalking and trying to land that left thrust.
Counter punch. Count can get a knockdown. But he's business. You see, the Prince just will not finish up with a shot. One, two, three, and he's in. He comes back.
Very professional.
Fat chance.
Left hook upstairs by Barrera. Big
left hand, but he hasn't thrown anything with it. He's missed it. He's depending
on shot. He can't get done here. There's a big left hand.
Barrera's playing possum.
There's a hard right hand by Naseem. And Barrera comes back with two left hand shots of his own.
But it's there right now. The Clint Steele pass.
The combinations have been thrown by Barrera to rescue his unbeaten record and his superstars. Hard right hand by Barrera.
Such. Well, see, even though, I don't think he's ever been hurt in a fight, but when he gets hit, his head is up. Naz has got to try to land a big knockout punch. So,
thank you.
And then Rob just quoted to you, it is Marco Antonio Barrera to turn it against him.
Naz will not come back with any shot.
Huge right hand by Barrera.
That the Prince has developed since he was a boy is being exposed.
Short left hand gets into the ropes. They're 3 minutes away from the conclusion.
This is the last round, and all you gotta do is box them.
You can't back up, you've got to bend down and go to them with short punches.
11th round, so in the last six rounds, Marco's won five of them. And they did the better shots.
Look at the right hand.
Not taking that advice. He's going for it.
He's been on the wrong side of at least one decision. A reckless.
Just got to close strong.
Hold it.
The Prince is trying to figure out how can he...
With his chin, one left hand won't do it.
That's true. Too much chin.
Barrera pounds Naseem into the ring post, risking disqualification. From a
veteran fighter
who has wants to touch in that gloves. Position. Barrera doesn't want to touch any gloves. Barrera wants... Big left hook by Barrera before the fight. And if he loses, it's because it has been written by Allah here. Suggest that Allah knows how to spell Barrera. B-A-R-R-E-R-A.
You should be... His moment of truth has turned into an hour of torture.
Is wandering around aimlessly in his own.
By unanimous decision, Marco Antonio Barrera.
No, si yo recuerdo, I remember that when I fought, I put pressure all the time. But in the gym, we work, move fast, all the time, because Hamed is paying my students, put pressure, a change in the fight.
Yeah. I've always seen him be a counterpuncher, and when you charge him and you miss, and he will counterpunch you. This time, we tricked him.
Tough fight for you. Why was this fight different for you than all the other fights you fought?
I don't know, maybe it's as I've told you before, Larry, but the answer you give me is you can't interview Allah. The fact is, my faith is still there to the maximum. If that's the way it's written for a man to go, that's the way it's written from Allah. I'm happy, I'm still confident. The fact is, he couldn't drop me, he couldn't knock me out, and I'm going out at this ring like a champion still. At the end of the day, I give him all congratulations and all the success in the world to him in the future. But the fact is, he's the pure winner tonight. I congratulate him. And that's it. He didn't plan them tactics. He planned to box. And his boxing skills paid off.
Why couldn't you?
Well, Jez, that's just the way it goes, my man. I tried so hard to knock him out. It's not that I relied on that power. It's just that I wanted to knock him out so bad. I trained so hard. And it didn't happen. I suppose it's, that's just the way it's written.
So it's my best fought, because Naseem Hamed in the time is a destroyer, power, difficult style. And I come in, I box it, I win. And he say, bite this beautiful sport, but
he can't do nothing. Yeah. She broke him down, yeah. You know, mentally, everything. You know, it was just, that was it for him.
Were you surprised that he never fought again after your fight?
Yes, I was surprised because I traveled to 2K to say, come on, let's go to second fight.
Rematch.
No, I finished.